It's time for Mr.
Fundamental.
Presented by no one.
Just a quick announcement. I have a deadline coming up, so I won't be doing Twitter polls for the coming week. I will still post some general breakdowns on specific players and a certain team's defense, so stay tuned. Both the Miami Heat and Toronto Raptors had an amazing start to this season, and a similar record before this game. The Heat have been beating up sub-500 teams, and gotten mixed results with playoff teams. In comparison, the Raptors have been dominating against every opponent, good or bad. Tonight's game was a measuring stick for the Heat in terms of their success, and a preview of a potential playoff matchup. Both the Heat and the Raptors are great defensive teams, and that's how the game started. The Heat ran a double screen for Butler. Lowry glued onto Robinson and prepared to switch. Nunn's cut would have opened up a lane for Butler, especially since OG was icing the pick and roll. Gasol smartly sinks down to contain Butler. Siakam was in position to tag Bam, and Van Vliet stoned up the weak side. While Bam is capable of making a jumper, the Raptors would give up that instead of a shot at the basket or a three. Bam doubts himself and almost turns it over. On the handoff, Gasol hedges hard since OG was trailing, giving him some time to recover. They double Butler, and Van Vliet tags the Roman. He doesn't fully get in front of him, because he needs to recover on Nunn if there was a kickout. Also, Siakam was in great position, with Lowry zoning up the weak side. Bam doesn't make the same mistake this time, but his shot goes in and out. It didn't take long for the Heat to adjust. They set that same double screen for Butler again, but going across the court. Look at this no-look by Butler. It forces Van Vliet to leave Bam early, and even Siakam was going to recover to his man. Great decision to take the floater, especially since Van Vliet was rotating down to cover the corner shooter. A quick push up the court got Butler in the post. The Raptors double, and great ball movement leads to a three. With Robinson heating up, the Heat had him running around the court to bend the defense. Gasol shows on the handoff, leaving Bam open, and gets the floater to fall. On the other end, the Heat were very disruptive, and had a great defensive matchup in Bam against Siakam. Siakam sucked in Leonard and tried to hit Gasol, but Bam was able to deflect it. They do recover the ball and got the defense scrambled. A nice pass by Van Vliet, and an extra one to Siakam gets him a floater. Lowry blows past Butler, but didn't have control of the ball because of Winslow. Lowry throws a nice bounce pass to the cutting Siakam, but there's too much traffic, since Leonard got his hand in there as well. Siakam resorts to a post fadeaway with the shot clock winding down, and Bam contests well. The deadly inverted pick and roll of Siakam and Van Vliet or Lowry was also neutralized with Butler guarding the latter. They'll simply switch and Butler gets a nice contest. When it's not Butler guarding the screener, they will hedge and let Bam recover. Siakam has developed this pull-up jumper, but is not as efficient as his drives or catch and shoot threes, so this is a win for the Heat. The Raptors were still generating good looks, like this wide open three by Gasol. In transition, OG finds Van Vliet in the corner for a wide open look. Now, here's some good coaching. Nick Nurse ran a play to get Van Vliet that same corner look, and they get rewarded for finding his hot zone. However, the Raptors just weren't making shots after that. The Heat continued their balanced attack and used Butler's gravity to create openings. They hit Butler at the wing. A double pin down for Robinson distracts the off-ball defenders. Nunn gets a full head of steam, and a dunk. The Raptors trap Butler, and Olynyk slips for a mid-range jumper, allowing the Heat to lead by 9 after the first. The Raptors continue to miss shots in the second quarter, and early in the third, but these are pretty good looks as well. They were able to cut into the lead by doing two things. One is pushing the ball and getting out in transition. This got them attacking the rim more before the defense gets set. The other thing is attack Robinson. They didn't get OG to go 1-on-1, but they forced Robinson to a tough spot with some precise cutting. Look at this beautiful read here. The ball gets swung to Lowry. Van Vliet cuts at the exact moment Robinson was getting into one pass away position. A great pass by Lowry gets him a basket. A pick and pop causes Robinson to close out. When OG attacks, Bam's position throws off Leonard, and he closes out on the high side. When Bam steps back to Siakam, OG had a wide open lane, and Leonard couldn't do anything with OG that deep in the paint. The Heat didn't do themselves any favors by settling for jumpers. Butler came back in to stop the bleeding by attacking the basket, drawing the foul here. They also countered the Raptors zoning up the weak side by having Bam at the high post and sending a cutter through, getting shots at the rim. With the Heat starting to build up a lead again in the third, the Raptors went into a 2-3 zone meshed with a box and one. They had one defender glued to Butler, and the rest were in a 1-3 formation. This lets them neutralize Butler as a shot creator, and cover corner shooters as well. Powell gets caught sleeping, but was able to recover and force the miss. The Heat tried to counter with Butler's screening, and a stretch big out on top. This was an open look, but the Heat cooled down from their hot shooting. After this and one by VanVleet, the Raptors were only down by two at the end of third. Interestingly, one of the Raptors' strengths was what allowed the Heat to build another lead in the fourth. They ran Lowry with the bench, consisting of Davis, Powell, Hollis Jefferson, and Ibaka. With three energetic maniacs, their aggressiveness pushed past the point of effectiveness, and Davis takes an ill-advised three. They did push the pace, but Powell throws up the shot before he had control of his momentum. If you squint past the fact that you can get soft and ultra-soft toilet paper, you can see Hollis Jefferson out of control. With the starters back in with Powell, the Raptors started their comeback with some quick ball movement, leading to a corner three. Pay attention to the corner here. Gasol and Powell seems nonchalant with their movement, but Gasol sets the back screen when the defense lets their guard down. This three gave them the lead, with under a minute left. With the game tied, the Raptors went to Siakam. Jones Jr. does a good job being physical, but Siakam goes to a spin move. When Siakam gets in the lane, he tries to initiate contact, but Jones Jr. rotated his body away. Since he's off balance, Siakam couldn't elevate, and with Jones Jr. going straight up, the Heat forced the miss. On the other end, the Heat went to their superstar, and Butler created great separation, but misses the shot. In overtime, it was all Miami Heat, or should I say, Jimmy Butler. He went 3-for-3 at the start of the extra period, and capped off an 8-0 run with a steal and jam. As a last effort to come back, the Raptors went into a full-court press, and they managed to force some turnovers. They couldn't capitalize on the offensive end, and missed these wide-open shots. The Heat left the door open by turning it over and taking shots early in the clock. But Powell's free throws were their only points in overtime, and the Heat took this one. This was a great test for the Heat, since this was only the third game against the Eastern Conference contender. They were able to pull through without their scorer off the bench in Dragic, and a balanced attack could be the kryptonite of the Raptors' stellar defensive game plan. As for the Raptors, they were integrating both Lowry and Ibaka back into the offense, after adjusting to winning without them. Poor shooting nights will happen. It's rare that all Lowry, Siakam, and VanVleet went cold at the same time, but I doubt that will happen often. Thank you for watching this video, and I hope you enjoyed it. Please give it a like rating down below, subscribe, and I'll see you next time.